Harvey will send it out towards the right wing. Out with Fox again. Spinning around in traffic there. Binta Diatta tried to lay it up and in towards the rack. It fell short. Ball goes out on the baseline. It stays with Fresno State.
And right there on that block in the midcourt, it's what Adair really wants this team to focus on. They need to get better on the 50-50 balls so they can score points in transition.
Fox, left wing three, wriggled out, rebounded by Khadisha Touré, making her first appearance of the day. Out with Simmons, rolling down the right side. Back it out towards the wing, in towards the top of the key, rolling towards the left wing, gives it off towards Brown, who drives towards the bucket, right-handed off the glass and in. 14-13, Sun Devils trail, 3:26 left to go in the first quarter. Rolling down the other side, it's Wittenberg, left-handed off the top glass and in. Answers the other way from the German. Here comes trying to crisp the Goodyear Arizona native, spinning around, wriggling around on Fox. Let a shot go up, and she'll head to the line to shoot two.
Other than that first push by the Bulldogs early on in the quarter, ASU hasn't even made them use the shot clock at all. They've basically had a free lane over to the paint and just to get easy layups over and over this game. ASU's got to do a better job pressing in on that defense.
Triana Crisp, first free throw, off front iron. She's coming off back-to-back full game appearances, 40 minutes against U of A on Sunday and 40 minutes against GCU on December 8th. 12 points, 4 rebounds, 1 steal. She misses the second free throw. It's back with Fresno State. At the Footprint Center logos, Harvey dribbles in. Now with Fox on the top of the key, tries to feed it in towards Diatta. She's at the right wing now towards the point. Lofts it over. Wingled around with Wittenberg. Now Diatta, toe on the line, just beyond the top of the key. Towards Wittenberg. She might have dribbled it off of Sun Devils. It goes towards the backcourt. Double team. Wittenberg tries to get it back, and the shot clock buzzer will sound. A violation called on Franca Wittenberg. Doomed from the start after the ball went into the backcourt.
See right there, though, the Sun Devils forced him to use a lot of the shot clock and eventually putting pressure on him, get in the middle of the pass, push it across the court. ASU gets themselves the ball back.
With Crisp on the right wing, guarded against Harvey. Crisp rolls towards the semicircle with Simmons on the left wing. Back with Crisp at the top of the key. Crisp surveys her options, bounce pass with Thompson. Thompson rolls down the left lane, right-hander, no good, but a foul called underneath by Mia Jacobs. Fresno State now racking up the fouls out of the timeout, the media timeout, that is. And now Journey Thompson heads to the line for the first time today.
And this is where ASU thrives. They force teams to get a lot of fouls. And again, they're one of the leading teams in the country in free throw attempts. So it's a lot of free opportunities for them. They have to take advantage of them.
Thompson will make it once again. 2 for 2 from the line there. So we approach 2:11 left to go in the first quarter. Press able to be broken by Fresno State out on the right corner. Fed in towards Santa Maria, and now down the line towards Jacobs. She lofts it up. That's no good. Rebounded by Jacobs at the paint. Works it out towards the right wing. 17 seconds, 16 seconds on the play clock. That's stolen back by Thompson with her backside on the floor. Now Simmons rolls down again, stripped by Harvey. And the foul called. It will stay on the baseline with the Sun Devils.
What a play by Thompson, being able to just have the body control to even stay in bounds. I thought she was going to be ruled out for a second there.
Touré working her way around. She wriggles it in. 17-16, Sun Devils lead. They have their first advantage of the day. 100 seconds left. Another dribbler towards the end line or the sideline it goes. Will stay with Fresno State. And Natasha Adair, she said that she was going to get her players back in the lab, get them more on a defensive side, and it's showing here in this first quarter. Back to the top of the order here in Phoenix. Sun Devils tied 1-1 with Cal as Harris Williams returns to the plate. Made it to second base off a throwing error from the pitcher, Trey Newman, who deals and will log the strike. one headed towards the upstairs part as Williams let that one go on the 86 mile per hour. 0-1, Williams showing bunt, he'll let that go. This time it's a ball towards the outside.
Yeah, Williams placed down that bunt in the first inning. E1 all the way to second base and scored the first run for ASU.
1-1. Swing, it's a high fly ball to right center field. The outfielders look back at it. It's gone. A solo shot from Harris Williams. A fist pump with the right arm as it just sneaks between the College World Series banner and the Jumbotron. ASU takes the lead up 2-1 here in the bottom of the third.
Yeah, that's his fourth home run as they all pound together. He plays down the bunt. This time, he swings it all the way. 2-1 here in the bottom of the third inning. ASU takes its first lead.
Harris Williams, a man who's pretty eccentric at times, but also a fun-loving guy in the clubhouse, and he delivers a big hit to start this third inning for the Sun Devils. One spot, two spot, Ryan Campos back to the plate against Newman. First pitch, again, from our angle, lower left-hand side for a strike. Campos with a 4-3 ground out in the first inning. Getting a second crack here, 0-1. Outside, 84 miles per hour. Campos, kind of a little bit of a rough start. I wouldn't say too rough, but had a rough first two games. Really popped off in the last game against Santa Clara. 1-1 pitch goes down to the dirt. And again, this guy has had a pretty good career when it comes to just getting on base at times. You know, you may not be the guy that gets the big hits, but 92% on base percentage dating back to last season, pretty good. 2-1 just paints as the strike zone for strike number two.
And he's got those 7 home runs so far this season, leads all Sun Devils. He has some pop in that bat as well.
2-2. This one chopped. It will stay in play. It goes towards Schulz. He will chase it down towards the bag for out number one. So now Nick McLean returns to the plate. Ground rule double opposite way in the first. That gave way to the Sun Devils tying the game at one apiece. And again, a man that homered, a 3-run homer in the third inning last night. Once again, back at the plate here in the third. First pitch from Newman will go towards the dirt for a ball.
Yeah, and that last, the top half of this inning, he took away extra bases from Cal with a jumping catch out in right field.
1-0, fired well outside. Newman has been going towards that area today when it comes to his pitches. And seen 34 pitches already from him. This is 35, down to the dirt. And McLean can basically just wait on this one. Well ahead of the count here. Newman against McLean. One down, 3-0 pitch. McLean decides to swing for it. And he'll pick up his first strike.
Get an aggressive swing there. Top of the zone pitch there from Newman. But he's still ahead of this count right now.
3-1. He sees this down to the dirt. Ball four. McLean takes base.
Thanks, Brady. It's been a rough week for Arizona State baseball as the Sun Devils offense has been cold. In fact, as cold as this ball that's been in my freezer for quite a while. Anyhow, the Maroon and Gold were back at Phoenix Municipal Stadium earlier this week for a 2-game series against Utah Valley. The first game on Tuesday night started with the visiting Wolverines up 4-1 early, but the Sun Devils chipped away and chipped away before a big hit by Brandon Compton, sending the ball over the right center field wall, and that 2-run shot by the freshman designated hitter gave the Sun Devils the lead in the bottom of the fifth. And hey, hitting may not have been good, but the pitching, absolutely stellar. Hunter Omlett in relief strikes out the side 1-2-3 in the fifth and sixth inning. He had 11 strikeouts and 5.1 innings pitched while also logging the save. Arizona State hangs on to win 5-4. The second game, which took place on Wednesday afternoon, saw the Wolverines get their revenge. Similar to Tuesday, the visitors started out hot, winning 5-0, but this time the hosts could not come back. Despite getting the bats going late, they lost 7-5, and it led to a players-only meeting after the game. The Maroon and Gold is back on the road this weekend for a three-game series against Washington State that starts today at 4:05 p.m. The Cougars enter the series 12-8 on the season, 2-4 in Pac-12 play, fresh off a midweek series sweep against Seattle. So let's see. Can the Sun Devils, just like this baseball over here, warm up by the end of this weekend?